Let's say that phone is my dick, hypothetically, and the charger is a pool.
Sir, is your dick stuck in the jet?
Precisely.
Are we on Joe Rogan right now? Joe, listen, dude, thank you so much for having us. Wow, this studio looks really good.
We're not on Joe Rogan. I'd love to be, though. That'd be great.
Yeah, we can. Soon. Yeah. I feel good about it.
Yeah, you know, it'll happen. Believe the speak into existence. Believe the process.
Does that work? The secret?
No. Are you into all that stuff?
Okay. Initially,
You're a glass half empty guy, aren't you?
I'm very glass half empty. I also like to make fun of all that stuff, but I think I like to make fun of all that stuff because I actually believe in it.
Right.
And I'm scared of the part that believes in that.
If I was like, I'm a Capricorn, you're like, yeah, you fucking know you're a dumbass. And deep down, you're like, Geminis actually sacrifice everything to give what they can to be a better person.
I hope you're a water sign because I go really well with water signs.
What is a water sign?
I don't know.
Water park?
Nepotism.
How much pee is at a water park?
So much.
How much cum is at a water park?
A lot, but not as much as urine. Babies don't give a heck darn it. First of all, babies, I don't give a heck darn it. I'll pee in a...
Dude, I had a friend who gave up cussing for Lent. And I was like, I feel like there's... Like, pick what you want a lot, but all my other friends would do, like, not eating meat, or I'm not eating, like, something else, but not cussing, and I'd forget. And then I would, like, see him every once in a while, and he'd, like, stub his toe. He's like, ah, heck. And I'd be like,
I think heck is worse. I think if you stub your toe and you say heck, you have bodies in the trunk.
Oh,
who are you?
Go up to a girl, you trying to frick? What does that mean?
I don't know.
What does that mean? Honestly, play with tech decks? You trying to frick?
Remember we were talking about earlier in the last episode or whatever, two episodes ago, but like what are the good things to kind of a spark of a conversation with a girl? I think that's one of them.
What?
Because that's
frick?
Silly, right?
Trying
you walk
to frick?
Up to a girl and be like, hey, excuse me. Yeah. You trying to frick?
I guess, but like...
Did you ever frick dance? Did you ever call it freak dancing?
Freak dancing.
Isn't it funny that like, what is it called now? Fucking? What? It's
freak
just called,
dancing?
It's just called
grinding.
Dancing.
Grinding. Yeah, but that's like the modern dancing.
But it's just like back in the day, it was like freak dancing. Like it was like, ooh, now it's just dancing.
Yeah.
Like if you say, hey,
the
you
whole,
want to dance.
The whole like twirl around and do all that shit.
That's not real,
nah.
Folks.
Throw that ass on me. Goddamn.
Yeah, you ever tango and they just throw it around? Just give it to me.
Dude, I asked a girl, I think it was a girlfriend. I was like, when you're like backing up on a guy, right? Dancing on him. Do you feel them getting hard? And she's like, yeah. And like, I suddenly had all these insecurities back when I was in like middle school being like, they knew I was hard.
Yeah. Hold on. You honestly thought you were like, oh, I'm getting away with it?
I just didn't know if they're like, these jeans are awfully tight in the seams. I don't know.
I don't know
what a fucking surrogate is, okay?
That's true. Dude, it's just unfair, man, because when you're that young, you can get hard smelling Wendy's fries, right?
What do you mean that? Yeah, I get hard like that right now.
Dude, I ordered Chick-fil-A last night.
Hard?
Oh.
What's the order?
Oh.
Where are you putting Chick-fil-A?
You know what the order is.
Chick-fil-A, you put that top over everything?
Yes. But you know what the order is, right?
What?
We've ordered Chick-fil-A together 400 times.
Yeah, but what is you go OG shit?
I go usually OG shit. I go spicy chicken deluxe sandwich.
Uh-huh.
Waffle fries, of course. Bottle water.
Do they have other fries besides waffle fries?
If they do, they should get rid of them. Who orders them? No one? Hey, I would like some...
One time I got the fruit at Chick-fil-A. Not bad.
Listen, I'm positive the fruit is good, but if you order fruit at Chick-fil-A, maybe... Maybe you should move away.
Yeah.
Out of town.
I mean, like, I love Chick-fil-A, but now since I can't eat, like, flour due to my fucking stomach, I have to get, like, the unbreaded, it's just chicken cubes, and I get it with fruit. It's so sad.
I don't know. The chicken cubes are not bad.
You got to douse them in sauce.
Yes.
They just don't do anything. You're not like, woo, Chick-fil-A. You're like, eh.
Well, couldn't you order a Chick-fil-A sandwich, the grilled one, with no bun, and just kind of dunk that in Chick-fil-A sauce? Oh, you don't like tomato. You like lettuce?
I like lettuce.
Right,
oh,
you don't like
make
tomato.
A lettuce wrapped Chick-fil-A?
Yeah, essentially.
They could do that. Their lettuce is kind of girthy though.
Their lettuce is fancy. Their lettuce is like you would sell it in like a Gucci store.
Yeah, I mean their lettuce has been through some shit. It's got some terrain on it. You know, it ain't no iceberg. In-N-Out's got that iceberg. That's what I love. They got that crisp, but like Shake Shack and also Chick-fil-A, their lettuce is a little more dense.
Yeah.
It's green, you know?
You could use it for a paperweight.
Yeah. uh-huh. construction paper.
Does anyone use paperweights anymore?
No. I don't even know what that is. Why is construction paper so much heavier than normal paper? Obviously, to do construction. Right. But like, what?
Construction paper. All construction paper is different color. Why do they call it construction paper?
That's what I'm saying.
Just
like if there's just like one color that you like write on, but like, yeah, pink construction paper? You showing up to the construction site with pink?
Let me ask you this. You ever hand make a card for somebody?
Probably.
You make a bitch wet. Hand make a thing?
But it's got to be good. Handmade is always better. But it's like if you just go on like art, what is it? Paint? On the on your computer, the program Paint.
Yeah, yeah.
And then you do like clip art, like a picture, and then like some writing looks like shit. I think you gotta like.
Well that's trash. It has to be handmade,
handwritten.
That's what I mean. Like handwritten, you write in like calligraphy, or like cursive.
Who are you writing cards for?
My mom.
But all right.
No.
If you're new to this podcast, Michael's trying to fuck.
No. Oh god damn. No.
Wait. Yeah, when was the last time you wrote a card for a female? Well, I guess like X or Valentine's Day or something.
I don't know the last time I made a handmade card for a female. I mean, but I will say though, if you do, because it's not so much the product, it's more so like, oh, he put in all the effort and he didn't just order something on Amazon. He really likes
me. Right. Plus, cards are expensive these days. You ever see how much a card? It's like
$9. $9? And you open it up and...
For a shitty one-liner.
Sings for you? I don't need it.
The singing ones are like $13.99. I'm saying $9, flat rate, shitty one-liner joke in the front. Be like, to the grandpa who drives me nuts. And then you open it and the squirrel's like, whoa,
it's
nuts.
Like holding a nut.
The guy who wrote that is like, I wanted to be a stand-up comedian. Nobody believed in me, not write for Hallmark.
Can you imagine writing for Hallmark? You just contemplate suicide every day.
Which is funny because you have to make the happiest cards.
That's what I'm saying.
But are they racked out?
No.
You think they get money?
No. Well, do they even have Hallmark employees? Or do they have people like, they just like send in ideas and they go, okay, cool. Like a bunch of freelance people.
Well, dude, that's what, so you know how Dove Chocolate, they have like some quote on it.
Mm-hmm.
So I opened one and I forget what it said. I made it said, your vibe is your tribe, right?
Trash.
Your vibe is your tribe, Libby, right? And I posted it on my like story and the girl who wrote that, like it's got sent to her and then she responded, was like, I made this like in college years ago. I just submitted it. So Dove was like, yo, hit us with some sappy shit that you'd find on a Forever 21 t-shirt and we'll print it for free.
No, did Libby get paid?
No.
Ugh.
Run me my money, Dove.
Yeah, I mean, how many times did Dove run that on the goddamn thing?
Who's in charge of Snapple Facts?
Also, we don't need it.
No.
Snapple Facts are interesting because they're facts, but who needs the vibe? No disrespect to
Vibe is
you,
your
Libby.
Tribe. But what does that have to do with chocolate?
Nothing. Just give me facts on chocolate. I'm interested in how chocolate was made. Why'd you choose Dove? Why wouldn't you choose a Falcon? Falcon chocolate?
Falcon chocolate? That'd be tight.
Fuck.
Falcon chocolate.
Falcon chocolate is
Falcon's,
like,
what are they only, what were you going to say?
I was just going to say Falcon chocolate is like dude chocolate and Dove chocolate. Like if you were doing some marketing shit, you'd be like Dove chocolate for women. And it's just a bunch of like hormones and it's just like good for your period or something.
I was thinking about just how it's all in the name, right?
Yeah.
Like those wipes you use, those wet wipes in the bathroom that are dude wipes.
Mm-hmm. They're just camo
color.
They
put dude in front of it and dudes are like, yo, I'm a dude and I'll wipe. I'm in.
How come they don't have cooler names for condoms? I guess Trojan is kind of a cool.
Trojan's
but
very.
But also like
Magnum.
Magnum is.
Magnum? Bro, I don't even know how to drive a Magnum car, shoot a Magnum gun.
Does Magnum mean big or does Magnum mean like
it
a
means
gun?
America.
Yes.
I don't know what Magnum means, but isn't it? Is it on the periodic table?
Yes. Magnesium.
Bro, I got the magnesium dick.
God. Damn.
Any periodic thing and they say it for it. I got that. I don't know any.
I got that tin dick. It's tinny.
Science teachers
copper?
Always got what?
Copper?
Copper cock?
Copper cock.
Science teachers got so pumped up when they got to go to that like one side of their room that had the periodic table.
They loved it.
They love going over there and be like, today we're going to learn about magnesium. And
Did they though?
I think so.
When you think back to the teachers.
My science teacher almost got that Me Too case.
Dude, my science teacher I found out later hooked up with a student.
Science teachers are always horny.
Why? Periodic table make your penis hard.
Probably.
Okay.
I mean, they're like, if you do a little bit of chloride and some and magnesium, come!
Real talk, could you name more than five things on the periodic table?
Magnesium.
Oh, that's bullshit.
Phosphate.
Okay, that was a good draw. Draw.
Good. Electrolytes.
Wrong.
Magnesium. I don't know. No.
Hold on. Let me see.
Go for it.
Can I say? I can't. Oh, okay. Copper.
Okay.
Nissan Maxima.
Yes.
Okay, hold on. I'll do it for real. Copper. Uh-huh. I think gold's on there.
Gold.
Is it not?
It'd probably have a cooler name.
Bitcoin. Is that Bitcoin's on there?
Bitcoin's on there.
Good. Okay.
Yellow 5.
Yellow 5.
Whatever the fuck's in Skittles.
B12.
B12.
I love B12.
Where's B11?
B11, retired.
Goddamn.
Guess what, Stiff Socks? Winning season has returned at MyBookie.
And winning season means doubling your first deposit.
Winning season means Survivor, Super Contests, and Squares.
At MyBookie, winning season means hitting all your parlays and props with your feet up, baby. Watching your team trounce their rivals.
Rejoice! It's time to celebrate the NFL season.
So invest in your intuition, baby. Use promo code SOCKS. What is it?
Socks.
One more time.
Socks.
Again.
Socks.
And double your first deposit. New players get up to $1,000 in free play.
God damn.
Designed to add more excitement to the sports you love and the games you bet.
From live betting to championship futures, every play you want to make is waiting at MyBookie.
It's simple. Make your picks, win big. Collect your cash.
Use promo code SOCKS. What is that, Trevor?
SOCKS.
And double your first deposit.
SOCKS. Your winning season begins today, only at MyBookie.
SOCKS.
Goddamn. How did we get on this tangent?
I don't know, but this is what I wanted to fucking... Well, I'm going to do a shift hard left turn.
All right.
Okay. So the girl that's coming this weekend...
Uh-huh.
Flying in.
Huh.
What's your stance on flying in? Bitch.
Am I paying for it?
That's what I'm at. Well, yeah, flying in. You're flying
I've
in.
Never done it. I don't know. I just, it's so much on the line because then it's like, I'm being here. I need to see a two-way ticket. Is it a one-way?
No, but the initial, hold on. It's a two-way, but the initial screenshot was just a one-way. And you know how you get the text screenshot and you only see maybe like 80% of the picture, like you don't see the actual
she
frame.
Moving in with you, fam. What are
yes.
you?
Yes, yes.
So,
she is.
So how long is she staying?
So she's staying 3 days.
Okay. See, for me, then that's 3 days that you're hanging out with just her.
Yeah, but I already done told her I need to do work on Saturday.
What are you gonna do Saturday?
What?
Okay, where's she gonna go Saturday though?
I think she's gonna kick it at my place and play with Greta.
And you're gonna go to the studio or you and got
I, oh I'm going yeah, I'm going to the studio. I got a bunch of editing to get done.
Okay.
For the Sunday clip, I drop stand-up clips on Sunday, so I need, because I don't have one ready. So I said to her, I was like, yo, Saturday, I need to edit a little bit, so I'll be gone. She's like, oh, that's fine, blah, blah, blah. I'll just play with Greta and take care of myself, whatever.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But.
That's 3 nights, though.
That is, no, it's 2 nights. Oh. Friday night, Saturday, she's bouncing Sunday morning.
Oh.
It was only 2 nights.
2 nights.
2 nights. It's just coming for a little fuck fest. You know what I mean? It's already laid out.
Oh. Boy.
Laid out the red
carpet.
That's
what's funny. It's just like somebody's like, wait, why are you going to Los Angeles? Get piped. All right. Have a good flight.
Is he a plumber?
I love Sorta. Seeing. You always know who's getting flown out. They're always in first class by themselves. They got fucking got brands you ain't even heard of. Machina Monomana. And you're like, what is that?
Balenciaga. Awful. Have you ever Balenciaga? Seen a piece of Balenciaga? Is it Balenciaga?
Yeah, but it's Balenciaga.
Yeah. Have you ever seen a piece of that fucking clothing? Dude, you're like,
they,
oh, I want
to. They had a shirt.
Never.
It looked like a joke almost. They had a shirt. It was a button-up that had a button-up on top of it stitched on it. I might have to show you for reference. Have you seen this? It's the most fire thing I've ever seen in my life.
No, it's not fire.
No, it's super trash.
Okay, trash, yeah. I've literally, you look at prices of this.
I can't even spell Balenciaga. If you can't spell Balenciaga, you can't wear it.
Is Balenciaga like, I would love to find out that Balenciaga is in Jersey. They just made the name cool because it's like Italian or some shit.
Here we go, baby.
It's got to be like in Paris, though.
Oh, my
God. Please give it to me. This is going to be so trash. Gabriel, are you looking at it, too? Oh, no, you're laughing.
This shit is fire.
No, it's not. Give this to me, please.
We'll put it up on the screen, but...
What?
It's a shirt with a button-up. Yeah, it's a button-up shirt on top of a shirt.
Dog. You already look...
Could your homie wear the front one?
I don't know. Maybe it's reversible. That's like when you nut in one of the magazine pages and the front two stick together And you're just like, here it is.
This is no, you know what? This is when you come on a t-shirt and you don't remember, and then you just find a button up in your back seat.
Stiff shirts. Why is that not our merch? Guess how much it is. Take a wild guess.
I already looked. I'm pissed. I already looked. Yeah. But it's
$900.
It's at $900.
What's funny
that's
is
nice though, 'cause it's two shirts.
What a shitty deal.
But what's so many funny things about this, because like if you're wearing this, everybody's like, what the fuck is that? But somebody who knows Balenciaga's fashion would be like, oh, yo, you wear that on Melrose, Fairfax area? They'd be like, dog, yo, what? You cop that?
But this is what fashion is, essentially what art is.
Yeah,
it's all who just makes it. You could take three eggs and just break them open with your dick and then throw them on a piece of canvas with your asshole. And then people are like oh shit, that. Who did that? And they go, oh, the floor general? And they go, oh shit, 40K. This has got to be 40K.
I mean, dude, that's what's funny about art is you can price it like you make its value. Like if you're like, it's a $10 painting, your brain goes, okay, that's a $10 painting. But if you're like, this is 10 million, your brain goes, oh, this is a $10 million painting.
Oh shit, I saw something on TikTok that was bananas and I'm probably gonna fuck the details up, but bear with me. So this is what really rich people do, right? So they make $100 million, right? So they have to pay taxes on like $100 million,
yes.
Right?
Yes.
So what they do is they hire a really famous artist to make a piece of art for like 10 grand. Then they take that piece of art and they have their other wealthy friends appraise the piece of art for $100 million. So then that piece of art they have is now worth $100 million. And what they do is they take it and they donate the piece of art for $100 million and they get the $100 million tax-free. So the $100 million they initially made, it's tax-free and they only had to spend 10 grand.
Huh?
And no one's following me?
No, I get it.
I actually explained it really well. I thought I was going to fuck up.
No, I get it 100%. I'm just saying that's crazy.
Crazy,
that,
dude.
That like the feds aren't like, that checks out.
But art, it's all subjective.
What does appraise mean?
Like, oh, this piece of art is worth $40,000. So you can hire, you can pay appraisal people.
How do you become an appraisal?
I think you're just good at the guy that's going, pork to the pig, $100. Wait,
no, that's an auctioneer.
Yes, it is.
Are those the same person?
Nope. I fucked up.
Wait, who?
An appraisal person, I'm sure you have to go to like some type of art school or whatever the fuck.
Oh, I just thought one of their homies was like, I'd pay 10 mil for that.
But that's what's so interesting about art and even really, I mean, I guess real estate's a little bit regulated, but art's not really regulated.
No.
Fashion's not regulated either. So what anyone will pay for it is what it's worth.
So everybody on TikTok is too concerned with dancing. I understand what the fuck that is, though, but that's like crazy advice.
Actually, dude, the TikTok that I saw, it was going crazy viral. I had like 4 million views or some shit. Because I've never heard of like that tax workaround like that.
Wow.
Because it's like, whatever the appraisal, it essentially just made up money.
Yeah, IRS is watching that TikTok like, interesting, fam, interesting. But I guess, I don't know where, you know, that's a legal thing. But
isn't that crazy?
But that means that the appraisal people are all under the table, like doing like the dark arts stuff.
Yeah, the fucking artist is doing dark arts, but the artist is gonna do it. Because now all of a sudden he got paid 10K for this, but now this piece of art is worth 100 million. I mean, obviously the numbers are fucking inflated for this example, but like the artist now has a piece of art that's worth, you know, 40 million or whatever, or what, 20 million or whatever. So this artist is definitely gonna do it because he's gonna make that 10 grand plus all his art. Like he's like, yo, I'm Michael. My last piece of art sold for 40 mil. So now this is my basement.
Damn, that's tight. Anyways,
show tight.
Girl's slowing out.
Sorry, I got off track.
I'm not really. I wouldn't. I mean, I don't think I would.
Never. No. You can't say never. Okay, so you don't ever meet your lady.
I mean,
you're single. You out here. You meet some girl over DMs. You guys are vibing. Blah blah blah. And she's like, I'd love to come visit you, but I'm kind of broke right now.
I mean, sure.
Yeah.
The hard part for me is to see like the longevity of it. I'd be like, oh, this would never work. She's coming from Seattle, but I don't want to like make this a thing. And then she moves down here, and then she's your only friend. Then you got a baby, and the baby's thrown up on your rug, and you're like, fam, what did I do to get here? This is all for some pussy.
But that's what it all is. That's what's so fucked up about this game. And I will go back to the thing. I will fucking coming is never worth it ever, dude. It's never fucking worth it, dude. Last night. I was having a fucking jerk session, fucking DMing, texting people like an idiot. All of a sudden, we're
that this, post and pre nut DM is bro, insane.
This girl, we were DMing back and forth, and I was trying to get her to come over, and she's like, "I'd love to, but like I'm already tired. Whatever. How about tomorrow? I work around where you live." And I was like, "Bet." Come through.
Oh, the prenup plans?
Come through. And then I come. And then as I'm cleaning it up, first of all, everyone, I'm cleaning it up now. I'm a new man.
Yeah, you're welcome. That's normal.
Thank you, Gabe. Thank you, Gabe. Thank you, everyone, for fucking shaming me. But I'm also the floor general, so floor gang, come holler at me. Listen, guys. So I come, and I look at my phone, and she goes, "Can't wait to see you tomorrow." And I was like, fuck. Tomorrow? I'm gonna be tired.
Here's the thing.
I'm gonna be so tired. Here's the
thing, though. You're gonna be horny in about 3 hours.
You can't
talk about a cum podcast for fucking 3.5 hours, get off from here and be like, well, I don't wanna fuck.
Yeah. This is the issue. This is the male libido. Maybe it's the woman libido.
Libido?
I can't speak. Huh?
Where's that?
Oh, libido's on the fucking periodic table. Libido.
Ibiza?
Ibiza, never went, would love to go. So,
I take a pill in libido.
Yes, so this is what the male libido is, and I can't speak to the
female. What is libido?
Female.
Donnie
sex
libido?
Drive.
Oh,
yeah.
I'm saying sex drive.
Libido sounds funnier.
It does.
Yep, anyways, so male libido is, and I can't speak to the woman libido because I'm not a woman, but I'm assuming it is like too. It's like an iPhone that's charging, right? Because when you die, meaning that you came, you're tired. You don't want to fucking
do
anything.
Your juice is gone.
Gone, right? But then you get a 20, 30, 40, 50%. You're like, hold up.
Then you're plugged in.
Yo, hold up. I could open Twitter.
You could actually unplug me right now. I think I could go a couple hours on 38%.
Yo, hold up. I could watch a YouTube video.
That's what I'm saying. What do you think the refresh time is? A good night's sleep. That's it. You wake up. Horny. You're telling me if you woke up to a knock on the door and it was her, you'd be like, well, gotta wait till 4 p.m.
Yeah, I'd be like, Greta, get the fuck out.
Greta, go on a walk.
By herself? Oh my God, I would love that. She could walk herself.
That'd
dude.
Be so funny if you saw a dog walking itself. Like, oh my God, it's straight. Nah, my owner's fucking. All right.
Yeah, she just, I just put a sign on her fucking side.
Oh, it's a service dog. Wait, no, what does the sign say? My owner is fucking. All right.
With construction paper?
Anyways, you nut. She texts you. See you tomorrow. Have you canceled?
No, I have not canceled because you were 100% right. When I leave this podcast, I'm going to be all horned up.
Horned up.
Horned up.
I'm going to be stuck in traffic on the way home.
Oof, I'm going to be
hard.
Nothing
gets you horned up like some traffic.
Dude, what is about traffic?
You see a bunch of bumpers and you're like, God, look at that back end. God.
Damn, is that Goodyear?
You see a fucking an H3 truck and you're like, hold the, who got that ass?
Who in the fuck is buying that?
Everybody. In South Carolina, I don't know.
Dude, I'm a bit, dude, every, it's really funny that you said South Carolina, that's where I went to college, and every, that was a hot girl car in my high school, and
H3
a hot
truck?
Girl car, yeah.
Makes zero sense.
Yeah, I mean, I've never actually even been in one, but I mean, gas guzzler?
Yeah, Hummers get like 8 miles to the gallon.
Maximum 8 miles.
Yeah.
Anyways, so the other girl, right?
She's, so wait, to wrap all this up, she's still coming over tonight.
I have not canceled. She's still coming over. And as I'm thinking about it, 100% going to happen.
What time is she coming over?
She said later. So I don't know what that means. I have no idea what that means. Hopefully I can get a workout in. Like, actually, like not a fuck workout. Like an actual workout. Maybe get a little editing done.
Get and the then, testosterone riled up.
God, oh, dude. I've been... when was the last time you did pre-workout? Like pre-workout juice?
Probably like 2 weeks ago.
Oh, you have some?
Yeah, some company sent me one.
Oh, God, dude. I forgot about it. I haven't used it in so long.
Yeah.
I got that C3 shit. We're not sponsored.
C4.
What'd I say?
C3.
C4 is hilarious. Isn't that an explosive?
Yeah.
Hence the
All
name.
The pre-workouts are like...
Yeah.
They're just crazy. M80 in your ass.
Yeah.
Tactical warfare.
Marines. Speaking of Marines, I just saw a...
Marines or Marine?
You're right.
Marine. What is that? A Marine who went to Mari?
Oh, God damn. I fuck a Marine. Maureen sounds old as Maureen shit. I'm sorry if anyone's named
name
Maureen.
Ever. Somebody, I know somebody named Marlene.
Marlene? That's a dog. Marlene and me.
Name. Marley and me. Great
Marley
movie.
And me. It
I don't even know
movie.
If I've even seen Marley and me.
I've
seen parts of it. Somebody was like, hey, the dog dies at the end. I was like, well, what's the point of watching that? What?
You've never seen it?
I mean, dude, I've seen probably 5 movies in my life.
Buddy.
Toy Story 1, 2, and 3 consume
first
most
of all, it's the funniest goddamn thing in the world. It's like a running gag in this goddamn podcast, and you've never seen it?
I mean, if Owen Wilson's the man, who else is in that bitch?
You had to turn and look.
Jennifer Aniston.
Jennifer Aniston in her prime. Fuck.
I know, but what's the dog? I don't like knowing going into it that the dog dies. Because then you're like, is this it? Is this it? Like the dog crosses the street and you're like, he's about to get hit. No. Any, it's that Final Destiny shit.
Any movie about a dog, the dog's dying. Didn't Air Bud die?
How do they pitch that? You love dogs? What if it dies? Whoa, hold on.
Huh? They go, hear me out. Jennifer Aniston's tits are there. Well, make it.
Are they?
I don't know. I've never seen it.
I doubt Jennifer Aniston gets naked in Marley and Me.
She does?
No, I doubt it.
Okay, but hear me out. Marley and Me remake, tits.
Marley and feet. Hold up.
Oh, all right. Shit. Wait. What the fuck are we at? Oh, have
girl,
I canceled?
Flying
no.
In. Not canceling. Nutting. Come.
Have I canceled? No. Is it going to happen? Who knows? But I'll let you guys know if next episode if it happens.
Dude, just send the firework emoji. You should come over tonight in the group chat.
Oh, I will. Oh, God. Oh, let's get back to the only
girl,
reason.
Flying in.
The flying in girl.
Yeah, what is this? Where's this going?
I'll tell you.
Now tell me.
Okay.
I'll tell you what.
I'll tell you what. So she hilariously sent me a picture and she went, I just secured the bag.
What the fuck?
And you
does
know
that even
what
mean?
The picture was? God damn. The picture was of a freshly bought leash and collar. Huh? From a sex store. Okay. A big bottle of lube. And to motherfucking set it off, she got a butt plug. I need a girlfriend. I need a girlfriend.
The funniest thing is, like, I don't, like, who's that for, though? You or her?
Well, we're going to find out.
5,000 Patreons, and it's for me. Is she?
Yeah, she. We already had a brief conversation.
Butt plug.
Yeah, because she, where do you think it goes?
I don't know. AirPod? And
I can't hear nothing. These are real good.
These cancel a lot of noise, but not as much as my Raycons. Cut to ad. Goddamn.
First of all, you know what I can't stop listening to? That new goddamn Drake. The laugh now, cry later in the autumn, whatever.
Sometimes cry.
Baby. I can't. I know it's over and play TikTok, yada, 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 but I can't fucking stop listening
to
it. So
good.
You know what I listen to it on?
What is that?
Raycon, new E25s.
Ooh, baby.
Johnson.
Dude, I'm not even going to lie. Those things fire, okay? How do you get that much bass in a dang earbud? It sounds like I'm at Coachella Live, but I'm really just in my Raycon.
Oh shit, you know why I like them?
Why's that?
Because obviously we fly a lot, and when I put them in my motherfucking ears during a plane, I don't hear nothing. No babies crying, no stewardess asking me if I want snacks. No, I don't want snacks, I'm good. Psych, give me those pretzels.
No, they're really great. They have 6 hours of listening time. They pair super easy. Just open it, throw them in. Case is super compact. All in all, 10 out of 10, dude.
And this company was founded by Ray J, Snoop Dogg, Mike Tyson, Rich the Kid.
Legends.
Fires.
And you know what? For our special and lovely listeners, we got a little promo code for you, baby. That's right. For limited time, get 15% off your order. That's buyraycon.com/socks. One more time. buyraycon.com/socks. 15% off your order. And you get 45 days. If you don't like it, you can return it, baby. What do you have to lose besides your eardrums? Blast those motherfuckers out with the new goddamn, I don't know, Drake, I'm outside in an AMG.
Baby.
Copyright.
Goddamn.
Anyways, that is... With, I mean, whoever doing TSA at security is going to be like, well,
oh my God, that's so funny.
I'll tell you what. Have you seen the stuff that like guys do in pranks at the airport? They'll get like a massive dildo and they'll tape a water bottle to it and they'll put it in their friend's luggage. So the liquid goes off
and
they have to open the luggage at the end. They go, whose bag is this? And then some guy's like, oh, it's me. And they go, is this yours? And they have a massive dildo attached to a water bottle and everybody, other friends are like, got you good fucking Ryan, you dumb bitch. And then one of the friends insecurely is like, hey, what are you guys doing with that dildo? Let me keep. Can I get that?
Yeah, we don't have to throw that away.
No, right? It's fucking, what, dude? Can't believe you had that. Put it in my backpack. What?
Dude, my backpack is my ass, so I call it my Jansport.
I was just going to say that. Wow.
Hey, Have we done 300 episodes yet? I'm actually excited though because
that's great. Your apartment is going to smell dramatically different from Friday night to Sunday morning.
Yes, it is.
You better open up them goddamn windows. Greta's eyes are going to be scarred. She's going to be like, I don't know what I saw this weekend. What are you doing?
She's going to have to wear sunglasses. If you've ever seen Greta with sunglasses, you know it was a fucked up weekend. But she's going to, things are going to get weird.
Stevie Wonder, what the fuck happened over the weekend? That's great.
I'm excited, man. I never
cool. Like that route is cool.
That route,
it's fun. You guys have chemistry. And you FaceTimed her?
I have FaceTimed her. She's very, very normal. She had what was a good indicator to me, and I don't know if this makes any sense.
She doesn't have a gecko.
She does not have a gecko, but you know what she does have? Two cats.
I love cats. What? I'm on board with her now.
Good. You're a lunatic. Gabe, where are you at?
Yeah, I'm good with it.
I hate everyone here.
Dude, each day that goes by, I'm closer and closer to getting a cat.
Please don't get a cat.
Dude, they're so tight.
Please don't get a cat.
They're so cool.
Please don't get a cat. What cat? What type of cat would you get?
Oh, no, cool one. Cats, like dogs have like different, like cats, there's like three breeds, like hairless, a Siamese cat, or just like a cat.
You're not gonna get a hairless cat. Oh, okay. Yeah, those
hairless
are demons.
Cats. Those are weird to love. You petting on it and you're just like, I feel like I'm petting somebody's neck.
Yeah, you're inside out. What happened? Did you get caught in a fucking fruit blender? What happened? Whiskers? How you going? Where's your whiskers?
Yeah, I don't know. I just think it'd be cool to have. Because I want my own place pretty soon.
Yeah.
Here, and I think it's a good way to not be lonely adding an animal to your life. But dogs, too high maintenance. I've seen you.
So
stressed
much.
Out. A lot it's, of anxiety. Dude, cats, fuck off. Go in a corner. Get you neutered once and you're good.
Dude, that is, I will fully admit, that is a great attribute of having a cat. Is literally you do nothing. There's no training. There's no nothing. With a fucking
it really isn't.
Dog, it's a goddamn nightmare. It's a nightmare. Well, here, you know what it is, dude? It's a nightmare for a little bit, but then everything you get from the dog after that is so worth it because you worked your ass off to fucking get there.
Yeah.
You worked it. Like, dude, the first time, like, I bell trained Greta. I think y'all know this, but.
What does bell train mean?
Bell trained?
You ring a bell when she comes?
No, I put a bell, a string in a.
Oh,
and
she hits it when she
has to
go potty?
And she hits it when she has to go to the bathroom.
I do that too.
Really?
For myself.
Oh, God damn.
Just for fun. I go, ding, ding. All right, time to shit.
You know how when you go to Trader Joe's and they get the ding, 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 ding thing when they need a, like a, if you go to the thing and you're like, I don't really like these Oreos. Do you have the white Oreos? And then the guy goes, hey, and he ding, ding, ding. And someone comes and gets you the right Oreos.
I don't know that.
Really?
No.
Gabriel, have you ever noticed that?
Really? Certain places, I forget where it is. Maybe it's like Jersey Mike's, but when you tip, they do a ding and everybody goes like, it was a good guy.
Don't they sing on some ice cream shit?
Cold Stone does that.
I've never seen that. You said they used to.
Yeah, they have to sing if you tip.
Can you choose the song? Is it like karaoke?
No, they have some scripted shit. It's
nah,
like,
fuck that.
Thank you for coming.
If I tip you $10, you're singing "Yeah" from Usher. Go.
I need Anita Baker now.
Go do it. You want this 20? You want this 20? Toy Story theme song. Go.
Oh my God. I just pictured that guy from that old insurance commercial. He's like, you want this dollar? You're going to have to work for it, right? You remember that one?
No.
No?
I'm sorry.
Come on. You don't know it either? Gabe, you're always on my side. What happened? You're paying him off. No. He has the dollar bill on the fishing line. It's a State Farm commercial.
Okay.
And he's like, you're going to have to work hard to get this.
Gabe, you're lying. You're looking up right now.
No, you
fucking lying.
You know what it is. Everybody listening knows what it is. Uncultured. Everybody knows what it is. State Farm.
This whole podcast is a hoax. Go ahead.
This is Joe Rogan podcast. No, but the guy has like a dollar and he's like holding it in front of this guy and he goes, oh, you're going to have to work harder to get it. And he has a fishing pole. It's whatever. But I would just keep doing that with Cold Stone. I put it in there, let him sing. I'm like, well, those octaves were a little off back there.
I need you to warm up. Is it ever good? There's got to be some Cold Stone where there's like two future Broadway stars that are just ripping.
I mean, dude, it's like when you go to karaoke in Los Angeles, like people are trying to get discovered at karaoke out here.
Dude, there was one cruise I did that they have karaoke for the fucking people that are on the cruise, obviously. And there was one girl that was like, she got up there. She must have been, I'm not shitting you, bro, like 10 years old. And murdering it.
Yeah.
Like someone signed this lady.
That's what she was hoping.
I think
but nobody
so.
On a cruise is going to sign you to anything.
Yeah, they'll sign you to more shrimp cocktail.
Yeah, which, might I add.
Oh,
do you
shit.
Like shrimp cocktail?
Yes, I do.
I just realized I don't like it. It's kind of bland, kind of boring. The shrimp is cold.
Yeah, that's the point.
I like cooked shrimp.
Coconut shrimp?
cooked shrimp. I mean, coconut, it's cooked, shrimp? But it's just cold. Coconut shrimp is fire. I had it recently.
How?
They had a gluten-free one.
There you go.
It's so good.
Dude, did you make it?
No.
Did I?
It was frozen. I already said some Whole Foods shit.
I already said it on this podcast. I made coconut shrimp in an air fryer. Fuck.
You made it?
Made it, bro. It's so easy.
You did? How the fuck? You
it's so
dip
easy.
Dip it in coconut and flour?
Literally, yes.
Huh.
It's
who was
real,
the first person to put coconut on a shrimp? They're like, yep. Well, it makes sense. They're both like tropical vibes.
Yeah, but I mean, there's so many other foods. You're like, how did you even?
The worst part about shrimp is when people do like shrimp tacos, and it's like they get away with only putting two pieces of shrimp in there because it's
more.
Like shrimp is a delicacy. It's a luxury, and you're like, you get two bites with it. What are you gonna half eat a shrimp?
I've went to a market, a fish market, a fresh fish market before.
A fish market
in Annapolis. Shrimp ain't expensive. Put more shrimp on the barbie.
But they're like mentally, they're just like it's an individual piece, so they're trying to, you know.
Everyone's trying to fucking stop trying to bamboozle me and give me three shrimp.
Somebody, yeah. Or I would even like it if they just like cook the shrimp how they do, and then just like slice it up into smaller pieces.
Word.
And then you got.
I think I would actually like that more because then it gets on more of the taco. Give it to me. Go ahead.
Do you like crab cakes? Oh, being from Baltimore, Maryland area. Were you? Uh oh, hot take.
Hot take. I don't like them.
Okay, I don't like you.
Well, guys, this is my last podcast.
Wait, what? Where is it? The price?
No, the price.
Those motherfuckers. I went to a place that said market price, and I was like, I got that. And then they're like, $20 each, and I was like,
no.
Whose fucking market is this?
I don't like market price because
market price is hilarious.
Here's the thing. You know how much it is. Give or
market
take.
Market price is just literally them seeing who's sitting at the table and be like, how much can we charge this person?
It's give or take a dollar, $2. So if it's $30 and maybe one day it's 32 and then another day it's 28, right? 30. Right? 30. It's the same thing.
Yeah.
The market price is, it doesn't, it's not the Dow Jones.
Hilarious.
It's not fluctuating 1,000 points.
It's fucking crab. Yeah. There's an abundance of it.
I don't know.
Really?
We're overfishing the ocean. That type of stuff scares the fuck out of me when someone goes, you know, we're not going to have any salmon in 2063.
Oh, that was
don't
a thought.
Tell me that.
Yeah.
Don't ever tell me that. We're overfishing. Then stop. We don't need fish. Who likes fish?
A lot of people.
I know, but this much?
Yeah.
Where are you at? You have to choose. Fish and no meat for the rest of your life? Or meat and no fish the rest of your life?
Meat.
Meat.
Give me that meat.
Give me that meat. Arby's, dog.
That's such a funny random clip to just take out of context. Give me that meat.
Meat. Meat all day. Gabriel,
yeah,
where you
I mean,
at?
There's
oh, you're
many more
like
uses. Think about what a cow can provide versus a salmon. Salmon's very one-off. You know, at most, what do you do? Eggs Benedict with salmon? I don't like it.
Also,
wait, no, like, I do like it. Oh, yeah. Smoked salmon's pretty good.
Yo,
that's what lox are.
Pretty
oh,
good.
Oh, fuck.
Smoked salmon.
I'm coming back. Smoked salmon's great.
Smoked salmon. Dude, lox. Oh, lox on an everything bagel toasted with cream cheese and chives and onion and tomato. Cut open-faced.
Tell
oh!
you. What?
I'll tell that girl bringing a butt plug to put it square in my ass.
I remember the first time I had lox on a bagel.
Fuck!
I was like, what? This is allowed? This is live?
Hold
this,
up.
This is just out in the world? You can just get it on any given day? It's not even like my birthday or nothing?
Why is it? Why is
it a full moon?
It tastes so goddamn
I don't know,
good.
Man, but that shit crazy good.
You know what's crazy good? You know who's crazy good at catching salmon? Bears. You ever seen a bear catch a goddamn salmon with their hands?
Are salmon the one that swim upstream?
Swim upstream.
Why
first of all,
why?
Swim downstream. Why you gotta swim up, you idiots?
But isn't that funny? It's like, there's such like those like edge lords where they're like, not only am I gonna swim upstream, I'm gonna fucking jump up and then hope there's no bear. Like they're like
yep.
in it like it's a wipeout course.
Yeah, and you know who catches them? You ever seen a bear catch a fucking salmon
yeah.
that's in the air?
Yeah.
God damn, are you Jose Canseco? You don't know who that is, but fuck.
I do, he's a baseball player.
I love you.
Yeah, his daughter's dating Logan Paul.
Pause, pause, pause.
Have you seen his daughter?
That's Jose Canseco's daughter?
Yeah, her last name is Canseco. That's Jose Canseco's daughter.
Man. I saw pictures of her because he made a fucking TikTok. He's like, this is my girlfriend or whatever the fuck he did. And she's bad. I would take her over salmon any fucking day of the week. Nope, I'm lying. Lox and bagels. We talked about it before. Have you ever had whitefish? Whitefish salad, I mean?
You lose me with this salad shit.
I don't understand.
Anything that's a salad that's not a salad, trash.
How are you a Jew if never had whitefish salad?
Gefilte fish? Gefilte? Nah.
Gefilte fish, get the fuck. I don't even know what that is.
Is that even a fish?
I think it's like
the fish. Dude, imagine being in the ocean, be like, I'm a gefilte. Am I late to the party? Oh, correct. Gefilte's here. Come. All right. We got to go.
Knock, knock, knock. God damn it. Gefilte's here. Gefilte. Jesus Christ.
I don't know.
I don't know what a gefilte fish is. Jose Canseco. God damn, dude. Can you imagine me and him just being so good at baseball? Also, your sperm makes a daughter like that?
I mean, it makes sense. He's one of the most successful baseball players in the world. He probably married like some model or some shit.
Yeah, but you've seen two hot people make an ugly kid by the thousands. Oh, yeah.
That's true.
Oh, yeah. Dude, yeah, there's a lot of ugly ass. Gabriel, can you look at, is that what you're doing? Gabe knows
ugly
exactly where we're going to go.
Baby hot celebrities.
Oh, right. Well, it's my computer, so whatever. two hot celebrities make an ugly kid. There's probably 100,000.
Yeah.
You know what's crazy? You want to feel old? I saw this recently. Macaulay Culkin, he's 40.
40?
Fuck. 40, bro. 40. Macaulay Culkin, this guy, 40.
How old was he in that movie?
4.
Okay, this is mean.
Yeah, wait, who's writing these articles and be like, well, actually, Steven Tyler had a child, you know?
Yeah.
You were seeing Steven Tyler's kids?
I don't know.
God, damn. What is this?
Who's that?
It's Bruce Willis and Demi Moore.
Well, Bruce Willis is disgusting.
Oh, okay, that's a good point.
But Bruce Willis.
Was Bruce Willis ever hot?
Yeah, well, Bruce Willis is hot in like, oh, he could fix my Ford Focus. Like he looks like
he's got a look, you know. And if you're into that look, you're
yeah.
Like,
but I don't think he's like objectively hot. He's like a mechanic hot. Like my husband's away.
He's like a mom on Facebook will get a little wet looking at him.
155,000%.
Who's Dennis Quaid?
Dennis Quaid, he's hot.
That's a hot name, Dennis Quaid.
Didn't we have a whole episode on Dennis Quaid?
Probably. Yeah. Oh, he was one that was like dating some like 20-year-old?
Oh, yeah. He's yeah. Living.
Was he him?
Yeah, he's like 60 something. He's got abs and dating someone who's like 21.
That's what's, it would be like a funny sketch or something. I don't know if it's funny, but it's like really random how like celebrities, like if on their dating app, is like, what's the age range? They're like 20 to 65. I'll take anything.
Yeah, also, like if you're that old, you can't do that. Like on a dating app, you shouldn't be allowed to go all the way down to 20. I mean, I guess you are, but what do you talk about? Teletubbies?
Yeah.
What do you have in common?
That's, I mean, I don't even know.
64 and dating someone 20.
You have nothing to relate about.
You have no idea. He doesn't know what TikTok is. No. He's a movie star. All she does is just like walk around and make him shrimp cocktail. Like, I don't understand. Dude, Omarion just married. He's like, I think he might be 40. He just married someone who's 19.
Jesus.
What do you talk? Like, I understand. Like, okay. Yeah. Just what do you talk about over Eggs Benedict? Nothing. You just go, how's the food? And she goes, it's good. And that's it.
She goes, cool. Take a picture of me in Boomerang. And he's like, Boomerang? I don't know how to throw a phone. The fuck?
Oh, goddamn. Are we in Australia? Fuck.
Goddamn.
Hey, what's up? It's goddamn summertime. You know what that means? Get less hair on your balls. Ain't nobody want hair on your
that's
balls.
That's what I always knew summer meant to me. I was like, nice weather and popsicles? No. Manscaped.
It's hot. It's hot. Who wants a 1970s fro on their peepee?
You want an UGG boot above your penis? No. Girls don't like it. Guys don't like it. Get rid of it. Manscaped, baby. We're here to tell you, all right? If you got a landing strip, you got a landing rip. Get that shit out of there, bro. Tighten it up, okay? Go to the barber. Tell him you want a number 5 on the side. Get your penis looking great, fellas.
Yo, also, I'll tell you what. When you got less hair, your dick look huge. Goddamn.
Less hair, more aerodynamic. You can fuck faster. Plus, if you... Right? And plus, if you got too much hair, you can't hear the sweet sound of the fucking.
True.
Right? So you want to go skin on skin. Round of applause. Baby, make the ass clap. Walk, flock,
speaking of ass, you can shave your ass with this.
Dude.
I'll tell you what. Personal experience. My goddamn ass is smooth like our marble floor. Floors. I love them. Guys. Go get Manscaped.
No,
also,
it's legit fire. It's got a ceramic blade, so you're not too worried about having like heavy metal down by your gooch. It's got a light on it.
A light.
The light is great because I use it in the shower. Well, first of all, waterproof. Hello? Hi? Question mark? How, there's electronics I don't get how they did that.
I don't know.
They're
either.
On their 2045 shit because this is amazing technology. You can shave your butthole in the dark. You can literally shave your ass in a cave.
Yeah. First of all, you keep hosing in the dark and you can shave your butt in the dark. That's where I'm at. Also, no, honestly, I've tested the waterproof because I'm like, I don't believe it. No, it fucking works, dude.
Not only does it work, but they just released their products in the UK, Canada, and Australia.
I don't think that was a good accent.
What are you trying to say about my accent? That's not good?
It was terrible.
Okay, well, if you use our promo code STIFF on manscaped.com, I will stop using this accent. And what does that code get you? 20% off and free shipping. That's manscaped.com. Promo code STIFF for 20% off and free shipping.
Upgrade that dong salon with the luxury products at Manscaped.
Goddamn.
Anyways, I'm excited about this weekend that's coming
girl
up.
Girl flying out, butt plug.
Butt plug. Dude, the picture she sent me just said secure the bag is so goddamn
funny. Secure the bag is wild.
Also, it's just really funny how she like went into a sex shop like it's 1973. No order on Amazon, nothing.
I don't find that weird.
It's, yeah, you should. It's why? A little, because if you're getting sex shit, you're going into a sex shop, you're ordering on Amazon, you specifically. Amazon, adamandeve.com, something. You're not going into a sex shop.
Shipping and all that, you know?
Shipping's free. What are we doing? Amazon, but 2-day
shipping. But it takes time.
2-day shipping. What are you
going to Amazon Prime a butt plug?
Yeah, you can.
You can do that?
I don't know.
All right, well, I'll be right back. that's so funny.
Yeah.
Is Greta going to get confused by the leash and collar?
God, I was like, this collar is a little big on me. Why are the chains on it?
She was like, oh, goddamn. You got another dog?
They do have butt plugs on Amazon, by the way.
Of course they do. They have everything on Amazon.
You can get multi-packs that have 3 to 4 different butt plugs.
Why do you need that many? Do you put a butt plug
like
in
different
to
sizes.
Starter?
I think it's like gauges. Yeah,
right,
it's like,
right,
so you
start.
Like,
you... Dude,
don't they
some...
look like a little spade? Like
yes.
Know, yeah.
Yeah.
Like.
But you know what's so funny? I zoomed in to see the size that she got.
And?
Extra
what does it
large.
Look like? Really?
No, it's small. I was trying to be funny.
But like compared to something? Like an acorn?
No. How
a
big?
Gumball that works out?
And no, it's bigger than that. I'm trying to think like
so
the
that just like goes in there and then it kind of, it's just chilling in there or does that just?
Yeah, it just sits in there.
I've never done
there.
The, I've while never, there's been one in there.
I have another. And
what,
that's what
does
that
do?
That's
you
what we discussed.
Charge a phone in it?
You could if
USB
you wanted
port?
To.
Like it just chills in there?
I think
it I just, guess it's the same as putting a thumb up in the butt.
It's exactly what it is. And I think when you move, it moves, right? So, Gabriel, can you look at
when
it
when I
like
move, the, you the move, just like that. That's the national anthem for butt plugs.
Yeah, what? Yeah, could you just like, so like what do butt? I mean, you know how to Google. I don't know what the fuck I'm telling you.
What do butt plugs do?
Yeah, what do butt plugs do? I guess the movement,
plug
right?
Your butt.
It's the it. Hold on, do females got a G spot in there too? They got 2 G spots. Unfair.
They got
2.
I mean, we probably do 2.
I think we only got 1.
When you, not, the sensory on the tip.
Let me ask you this.
That's kind of like a G spot.
Let me ask you this.
It's like a G pond.
Let me ask you this. When you come, can they keep touching you? Or you say, if you touch me, I'll throw you out of my house for life.
Not like.
You can keep getting touched? Like the same
yeah.
motion? Dog, you.
Yeah, it cripples me. I'll be like, ah! I feel like I'm just melting. I feel like I'm made of cotton candy in a goddamn thunderstorm.
Too much for me, though.
I like it.
You like it?
Yeah.
Too much.
I like it. I turn into a wacky inflatable tube, man. I'm like, oh, fuck. God.
Yeah.
Somebody bring me a bagel and some lox while I get my cocks.
I'm doing the Harlem Shake in Chicago.
So you're telling me your nut getaway.
I'm nut and you got about 3 to 4 more strokes until I go slow, 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 slow. I say that every time. Slow, 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 slow. Please slow.
After the nut?
Nut, and then you got about 3 more of these and then you got to go real, cause I'm dumb sensitive afterwards. Maybe I'm just a bitch and you can take it and you actually like that sensation. Mine is too much for me. I can't handle it.
Hmm.
But you're, Gabriel, where are you at?
No. I get super sensitive right after.
Oh, okay, good. Yeah. It was just funny. No, everything.
No to it all, no.
What if I meant like sensitive, you thought like my feelings? You know? I just want to go.
Have you ever cried after sex? Palms.
After sex?
Yeah. No, I haven't either. Gabe?
Okay.
No, yeah, I haven't. What do butt plugs do, Gabe, before we get into some talk?
So, butt plugs, what's the point? Pleasure, for starters. Your anus is chock full of sensitive nerve endings that
chock
also
full.
Feel fantastic when stimulated. Your butthole is also the gateway to the prostate, also known as the male G-spot, and the roundabout to the vaginal A-spot and G-spot.
A-spot?
Hold on. They got
is
an
there,
A-spot?
Is there a spot for every letter? What's the T-spot?
How many spots do women have?
A-spot, B-spot?
The A spot is located deep inside the vagina between the cervix and the bladder.
Never hit
it's
that.
About 2 inches higher than the G spot.
Never. 2 inches higher than the G spot?
Yeah.
God damn. I gotta bring someone else spot. In to hit that?
What the fuck?
I'm hitting the G spot. I go, hey, can you get in here and hit the A spot? I can't reach it.
Get a fucking ways to go up in that vagina. See what's going on.
Yo, you know at the fair when you have the hammer and you go, wow, and it goes real high and bing, bing, and let you know where you're at? I need that on a woman to tell me if I'm on the A or G spot. G, 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 A, A, G, G.
There you go.
She could tell me.
There you go.
So we know about the A and G and T and H spot. Gabriel, why don't you hit us with some little sakatalki?
Yeah. All right. We got a question here. This is from H double N A L Manzi. And they say, I've never had sex before, but my understanding of it, like my best guess, is that it feels like when you scratch a mosquito bite, like it really hits the spot. Is that close?
Nah.
That feels like when you first put it in. That's about the sensation. That's about the level of sensation right when you first put it in. Like the first, like you've been hard for a little bit and then you like first put it in. That's about the sensation meter of scratching a mosquito bite. But like, I'll tell you what, dude, and this is going to be controversial. Have you ever had athlete's foot? Like what?
Yeah, I think once.
You have? Okay. That, I'm telling you, athlete's foot on your feet and it itches so bad and you like take like a fucking metal, like I usually, this is gross, whatever, but I usually take like a key. When I had athlete's foot in college, I would take a key and fucking grind my foot.
Ugh.
And like, and it felt so fucking good that I was like, this is as close to coming as I could get without the actual coming. I'm telling you, I was like, yo.
It always comes full circle back to feet, somewhere or another. How'd your foot fetish start? I was keying my goddamn foot with a key of soul key, and here I am.
All right, let's do one more sock talk. This is from Amazona. She wants to know, Amazon. What would you call it when a woman is laying pipe? Like when she's really...
Pegging?
I guess it's more like
when
like
she's on top and she's
and
giving
going
it,
for it. Yeah.
And she's putting that thing in overdrive.
Yeah. So we're laying pipe.
Yeah. What's the female equivalent?
So we don't we have a pipe. They more have like an opening, like a slit.
They're kind of
laying slit.
I hate that.
I hate it so much.
Yeah.
It's terrible.
I think they're plastering. They're plastering that penis. I don't know.
But are they plastering? Because it's like.
I'm thinking if a girl's on top, right?
Right.
Maybe she's,
but she's going up and down. She's going bah bah bah. You know. So what is that?
Hammering the nail.
But they also say that dudes are hammering.
Right. So it's got to be something with like a slit, or like a fucking, fleshlight.
She's what's the when the pottery? What do they call that?
Kiln.
Fire in the kiln.
Oh, there could be something there.
Okay. Why can't we think of one?
I don't know.
I just want to know if there's one that like girls say that like we don't know.
Right.
She always goes, I fuck the shit out of him. Fuck. Do you want shit to come out of my butt? Is that a goal? Is that a goal?
Maybe that's what the first person meant, but they're like, that's good. I'm going to take that. And she's like, no, literally there's shit everywhere. I can't hear you. All right.
Yeah.
So, Urban Dictionary says the female equivalent of laying pipe is throwing clam.
Yeah, all right. Clam is
gross.
So...
Clam is disgusting. Clam, I think, was popular in 1953, and they just kept it there.
Because here's the thing. I love clam chowder, but I also love it out of a bread bowl. Yeast. There's too many ingredients going on. Now
clam is also a fish, and it don't smell great.
Clam chowder.
Clam chowder is amazing, but I'm saying just a regular-ass clam, that don't smell great.
I just feel like there's ladies, you know, there's better things out there to like compare it to, you know.
It looks, yeah, it feels like a, what about a magical cave? What about your, what about your splunking the shit out of me?
Or you're putting that, putting that debit card in the meat wallet.
Oh no.
Meat wallet is the worst thing you could call it.
Yes. What type of meat? Roast beef, have to be. Honey ham, maybe.
Yeah. Jesus. I mean, there's so many
Well, you can make anything be anything.
Bro.
Oh, shit. What'd you do? I hung the curtains. God am. You know what I mean? You literally anything. I closed.
I took the trash out, and it wasn't even a holiday weekend.
God damn! I went to the Apple Store. I bought two iPods.
They were both the Nanos. Oh fuck!
He got a small dick.
Well, right. I don't know, ladies. Write in. What's a better way to call it? Or what's your version of laying pipe?
Slamming the meat rocket.
Yeah.
Sorry, guys. All right, so we go one more.
Putting the hoodie on the Woody. There it is. I like it.
Oh.
Putting a hoodie on the Woody. Take it, sell it, put it on merch. $10,000.
Toy Story.
Lawsuit.
Woody. Harrelson. Woody Harrelson kind of looked like a dick, to be honest.
All right, let's just.
All right, let's do a secret talk. This is from an anonymous listener who says, one time my dick got stuck in a pool jet.
Hell yeah. Well, how?
I love these.
So was it?
He was
on?
Fucking it,
had to
it
be
obviously.
Off, but was it on or off when it happened? Like, you'd think it would be.
Maybe it, because sometimes I feel like they're on like a timer, so maybe it was going.
Maybe he was trying to fuck it.
Oh, he was
when it was on, and then it turned off, and then when it turned off, it pulled some suction in.
Yeah,
I think that's probably
kinda.
It.
What do you do at that point?
I mean, hilarious, because you got to call the fire department, and the fire department got to come. He's like, I'm used to putting out blazes of fire. Now I got to make sure your dick don't fucking break off in a goddamn spa.
But what do you say to the operator? 911, what's your emergency? Hypothetically, maybe there may be a guy here with his dick stuck in the jet. I don't know. There might be. It might be.
No, what's your emergency? All right. Well,
my
you
life.
Know how sometimes you charge your phone?
Let's say that phone is my dick, hypothetically. And the charger is a pool.
Sir, is your dick stuck in the jet?
Precisely.
She goes, is this Harold? Yeah, I did it again.
Again, I told you.
What?
I tell you what,
I would
though,
love for this person to write back and figure out how that went.
I'll tell you what, though. If you just jam a fleshlight in that fucking jet, there you go.
Fuck.
Hands-free Bluetooth. God damn.
Fuck.
Oh, dude, the guy who had sex with a honey-baked ham DM'd us and was like, I'd be happy to tell you more about the story. And I was like, I would be happy to get a very condensed version that Gabe listens to first and gives it to us. All right. I don't want some guy on the phone. He's like, so it's fucking a ham, right? It's broad daylight, huh?
Yeah, can you type it out?
Yeah. Can we get like a very like step A to B? All
right. I'm gonna be honest. Notes. That's what y'all want. I want it to be a live conversation.
You wanna see the ham that he
I might want him to Skype in. Zoom call? I want him to let me know exactly how it went down slowly. Step one. I went to Kroger.
Step one, I was drunk. Step two, I opened the fridge. Step three, my dick's through the pack of ham.
Step four, I had to move states because my roommate called me.
Step five, sandwich wasn't too bad. Didn't need any mayo.
Hold up.
Miracle Whip, that's my cum.
Miracle dick.
Miracle Whip's so good, you hate it. Well, guys.
I'll try it.
Listen, this is a science podcast, obviously. We're out of time. Damn it, guys. As I say always, we love you. Thank you so much for supporting Jesus. Thank you so much for supporting the podcast. If you want to join the Patreon squad, please do that. For only $5, you get 4 extra mother freaking episodes a month. So that's an amazing
and
deal.
And there's no ads on there.
Ooh,
at all.
No
it's
ads.
Just an hour of unfiltered nut. There you go.
Almond nut. Also, go on iTunes, rate, subscribe, and review. It really helps us out, please. And again, we love you guys. Thank you so much for listening. Bye.